So question number 12, we have this graph, and we're supposed to draw the graph of 1 half of x, of the function f of 1 half of x. So what I want you to think about, kind of like we did with the other ones, whenever we're inside these parentheses, we're dealing with the input. So it's going to, whatever's in here is going to affect the x. The other thing I want you to think about, when you're inside something, think of a mirror. When you look at a mirror, what's inside the mirror is actually opposite of what's happening outside. So whatever you do inside the function here sort of has an opposite effect. So while this looks like we're taking 1 half, sort of think of it as taking x divided by 2, right? That's what 1 half really does, dividing by 2. What we're going to do is we're going to take the x values and multiply them by 2. So let me tell you. So we've got this 0, 0. And we've got this other point we're going to highlight, the endpoints here. Again, with these lines, we could just, if we know where the endpoints go, we just connect them and everything else follows suit. This other point is 4, 4. So what we're going to do is we are going, this is actually a vertical stretch, horizontal stretch, I have to get my rights. So we're going to multiply each x by 2. So I just take my points and multiply the x coordinates by 2. So the new coordinates are going to be, well, 0 times 2 is still 0. So that's the nice part of 0, 0. But 4 times 2 is 8. The y values do not change because nothing is happening outside the function. So 0, 0 will stay where it's at. The point that was at 4, 4 now goes to 8, 4. So it's going to go there. And we just connect those points. So we'll use our Alex pencil, put our points there, and then we'll connect that with a segment. Okay, so just remember that anytime you're inside the function, it's like being Alice in the looking glass. Everything is backwards. When you're outside the function, as we'll see on this next one, everything works just like you think it would. Okay, so I'm going to clear this out. Let's go down to this one. So in this case, it's the 2 is happening outside the function. It's in the open. What you see is what you get. So what we're going to do again, this time we have 3 points. So let's go ahead and highlight those. So I've got the point negative 2, negative 4. And again, you'll find a way that works for you. You may just kind of be able to see this and jump your points around. I'm going to actually do it analytically as well. Again, this point 0, 0, which usually doesn't ever move under these kind of things because when you multiply 0, it doesn't change. And this point is 4, negative 2. But it sometimes makes it clearer what's going on. And so now this is telling us multiply the y values by 2. So let's go. First time I change. So the y values are going to get multiplied by 2. Y values multiplied by 2, y values multiplied by 2. And the new point is going to be negative 2, negative 8. This new point is going to be still 0, 0. Cool. And this point is going to become 4, negative 4. So we move those points to where they need to be, negative 2, 8, negative 2, negative 8, sorry. So that point there, 0, 0 stays there. And then we've got this point 4, negative 4. So this is a vertical stretch, as we can see. And so we connect those points with these lines, and we're good to go. So let's go ahead and use the pencil. There's that point, there's that point, there's that point. And again, you can see since it's on the outside, it's just going to affect the y values. So you could have just said, okay, what's this? Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. You could have done this without writing this down, but you might want to. Again, we all have to decide what works best for us so that we see and understand. Sometimes you have to do that one way a few times and then it becomes obvious, but that's why I stopped. And so this is what our new graph would look like. Thank you.